Hi everyone, my name is Debbie. Welcome to my channel. I am a reseller. I've been doing this for 16, almost 17 years. July 3rd actually marks my 17th year anniversary, so pretty soon I'll get to say 17 years. And now I'm also creating YouTube content, and I had no idea how much I would love this also, and how wonderful all of you guys would be, supportive, kind. So thank you so much to everybody that has subscribed. And if you are new here and are interested in reseller content, if you want to subscribe, hit the notification bell below, then it will let you know when I release new videos. Today's video is a what sold video, which is actually my favorite kind of video to watch. I feel like they're not only entertaining, but they're so valuable to know what is actually selling and for how much. And this past week, May 30th through June 5th, was a partial week for me. I went to Corpus Christi and had a nice little mini vacation. We had some good friends that moved there, so we went to visit them and got to go to the beach. And also, I went deep sea fishing for the first time ever, which was a really neat experience. We caught red snapper. It was just a really fun time despite getting a little bit seasick, but it was completely worth it to get a little bit seasick. So we got back and now I have a week to be able to put work in, and then we're going on another vacation in another week. Now I'd like to share with you what I sold last week. I had a total of 36 items that sold for a gross amount of $859.59. And as always, if you want the complete breakdown of how much I sold, my gross sales, how much I got back, cost of goods, all of that overall and on each platform, stick around to the end and I will have all the numbers for you. We will start on Poshmark. Again, this week I had the most sales on Poshmark, 27 items for a gross amount of $600.40. The first item was from my San Antonio trip where I went to Goodwill, and this was a pair of Works Red Wing steel toe work boots, and they were an olive green suede, just really nice. And anytime I see work boots, if they say things like oil resistant, steel toe, those type of things, often those can sell for a lot of money. This pair sold for $50. My earnings were $40. I didn't even send a shipping discount. They just purchased them outright. I paid $10 for them and my profit was $30. And again, I got them at the regular Goodwill store in San Antonio and they took 41 days to sell. The next item was from my Thread Up Rescue shoebox from the first one. I have two videos out now of Thread Up Rescue boxes. And this one was the Tory Burch Navy and Cream Cap Toe Ballet Flat in size 8. And this went to a viewer. Thank you so very much, Tammy. I was absolutely thrilled, so excited when I got the message from you and said that you saw them on the video. So absolutely made my day, my week, my month, maybe even my year. So thank you so much. It sold for $54. My earnings were $40.74. I paid $6.32 on the Thread Up Rescue Box, and my profit was $34.42. And they took, oh gosh, about a day or two to sell, so not long at all. And on that first Thread Up Rescue Box, I am already in the profit. I've sold 4 of the pairs of shoes now, and I have received back, after fees and everything, $108.40. The cost of that box was $94.84. So I am in the profit, $13.56 already, and I still have 11 more pairs of shoes to go. So I am thrilled with the Thread Up Rescue shoebox. The next item is a swimwear brand that has been selling consistently for me for a good amount. This is Go by Gossip. It is a 3-piece tankini set in size large. This set sold for $42. My earnings were $33.60. I paid $1.32, and this was that swimsuit deal that I got that was 66 cents each, and the tank and the bra that was underneath counted as 1, and then the bottoms as 2, so it was 66 cents times 2. and my profit was $32.28. I listed this set 6 months ago, and right after I got them, knowing that a lot of them would trickle out, and that's exactly what they have done. I sell several swimsuits every week, and that was just a great purchase. The next item was a bundle of five. I love getting bundles. They were all Free People bras from Liquidation. And again, you probably heard me talk so many times if you've watched this about Fox Liquidation. That's where I purchase all of my Liquidation items from. I've been so happy with them. And I thought I would show you kind of how the items come when I get the Liquidation. This is why it makes it so easy. They come pre-packaged like this. So what I'll do is maybe I'll have 20 of these. I will take one out, take photographs of those. The others I just keep in these bags, and when it's time to ship them out, I just put a cute little sticker on it, stick it in a mailer, and that's it. It is so easy. So these are just some of the things that I have gotten that I thought I would show you. And Liquidation is a great way to purchase things if maybe you don't have inventory in your area, or if you are at home with kids during the summer and maybe it's really difficult to get out in source. Liquidation is awesome. The threat of rescue boxes are also. This bundle of five sold for $70. My earnings were $56. I paid a total of $18.21. And my profit was $37.79. And these, you know, since there were five of them, a lot of them I've had for maybe 8 to 9 months, but multiple quantities, and they just trickle out. The next one was a Nautica tankini, and it sold for $27. My earnings were $20.10. I paid 66 cents, and my profit was $19.44. And again, this was my swimsuit deal, and this one I listed on the last day before I had the giveaway, when I said, I'll give away anything that I don't have listed. This was on the very last day when I was like, oh, I still have a lot to list. Whenever I have swimsuits, I am sure to take a picture of all of the tags when they say certain things like slimming, or this one had seamless fit, shape enhancing. Those are excellent keywords to put in your listing, and also to show the tags where they can see that the swimsuit does specify that. And one other thing on swimsuits is usually I will show inside the cups. People want to know, are they padded? Are they underwire? Is it a shelf bra? And so I describe it usually, but a better way is just to show them the picture of the interior bra and lining so that they can see exactly what it's like. Then the next one is another bundle, and I put this one in here because one of these items was a Rachel Roy quilted jacket in size extra large, and I have had this for like 3 or 4 years, and I purchased several Rachel Roy pieces, and they had a high value, really nice. I thought they would sell right away, and I just have trouble moving them. Does anybody else have luck with Rachel Roy? It seems like such a nice brand, but I just can't get them to sell. So I was so excited when this bundle offer came in, and they paired it with a top that is so cute. I kept one of these myself. It was the Babes in Bandeaus, and it's a Free People Liquidation again. And I put with it another bandeau because it's really low cut. And so I had a lot of these just nice lace bandeaus that when I wore the one that I kept, I put underneath, and I was like, that is perfect. So I put in there that I would include that for free also. So the bundle sold for $66. My earnings were $50.34. I paid $2.99 for the Rachel Roy quilted jacket, and it was brand new too. And I paid $9.54 for the Babes in Bandeaus bodysuit, $2.50 for the just single bandeau that I threw in there. So my total cost of goods on that bundle was $15.03, and my profit was $35.31. Then they made another bundle, that same person, and they bundled the Winnie high neck bodysuit, which has been an excellent one. I pulled that one too. This is it. It is so pretty, and I have had several of them sell in the 40s, and how much did I pay? $13.78. So this is one of them, and I thought I'd just show it to you because I think it's so pretty. And this is the Intimately Free People tag. So if you come across this, this one is a really good seller. And when I'm looking at the liquidation lots, if it has that one in there, usually I highly consider buying that one because I've just sold that one over and over so well. And they also purchased a galloon lace halter. So they bundled that together, sold it for $50. My earnings were $37.54. I paid $13.78 for the two items, and my profit was $23.76. And then she purchased it and I noticed, oh, that's the same person that just purchased two different bundles. So I sent her messages back, and often if they do that, I'll ask them if they want me to cancel it and put everything together in one bundle. But she stopped messaging me, and then the next day came and went, and I thought, you know, I like to have things shipped within 24 hours. So when I didn't hear back from her, I went ahead and sent it in two different packages. And usually that ends up working out, but there are a few times where I've canceled the order and then the person never repurchased it. And then I was kicking myself for canceling it, but you know, you just never know. Then the next one is another good seller that I had from liquidation. It is the Free People Gold Brush Sequin Dress. This one's in size large, and I have it also in black in multiple sizes. And these sell regularly, and this one sold for $40. My earnings were $32. I paid $8.44, and my profit was $23.56. Then the next one was a bundle, and a lot of times if I do see the swimsuits match size and pattern, then I'll put them together. But on this one, I guess I listed them so far apart that I didn't realize that they were a match. But the person found the tankini and the bottoms, bundled them, and purchased both. This was the Hula Honey Picnic Gingham Tankini and High-Waisted Bottoms. And high-waisted bottoms have been excellent. Those seem to sell really well for me, so I would be on the lookout for those high-waisted bottoms. The bundle sold for $30.40. My earnings were $24.32. I paid $1.32 for the two of them on my swimsuit deal, and my profit was $23. Then for the 10th item, the last item that I'm going to share for Poshmark, was a Camilla Bandeau in Vintage Rose. And I wanted to share this one because this is one that I have just trickle out a little bit at a time. And these are a good amount of my sales are just little things like this that add up. It sold for just $14. My earnings were $9.55. I paid $4.56, and my profit was $4.99, but that doesn't seem like much. But when all I am doing is just taking a package, sticking it in a mailer, putting the postage on it, and that's it, it takes so little time. And I had hundreds of these, well, maybe between 100 and 200, I'd have to look up the exact numbers, but I know in this color alone, I have 44 of them left. I've sold 13 of them. So just in rose, I had 57, and I also have black and cream and pink. And so if I sell 100 of them and the profit is $4.99 each, then that's $499 profit. So again, I just can't say how much I love multiple quantities. I really feel like that is the key if you have limited time and being able to make a lot of money per hour. On eBay, I'm continuing to relist items and get my numbers back up there with fresh listings. I sold 8 items for a gross amount of $257.67. The first one was in my Goodwill haul where I was doing the giveaway, and that's coming up again. Be sure that you watch on the 15th. I have another inventory giveaway. I'm actually going to record it right after this. And this was one of the items that I wasn't sure about, and I kept this item. This was the Polo Ralph Lauren, the mesh mini French navy dress in size extra large, and it sold for a gross amount of $41.58. My earnings were $31.77. I paid 75 cents at the Goodwill bins, and my profit was $31.02. So that was excellent. The next one was from another Goodwill bins haul. This was a Nike Georgia Bulldogs cap. It sold for $14.99, and I went ahead and put free shipping on that one. And people ask about shipping all the time, and I kind of look at each item individually. I offer free returns, but a lot of times if it's something that I think could possibly be returned, specifically women's items get returned a lot more often than men's items, I will go ahead and charge shipping, but then free returns. And but on hats, I don't think I've ever gotten a hat back as a return, so I thought I would go ahead and put free shipping on that one because I think it does help in the search results. It sold for $14.99 with free shipping. My earnings were $7.67. I paid about 20 cents at the bins. My bins is 99 cents a pound if you get over 25 pounds, and my profit was $7.47. Then the next one was from the Thread Up Rescue Box. And this one actually was on one of my videos where I was showing how to use Google Lens and how I price items to sell them. So this was my pair of example shoes, and they sold for $32.85. My earnings were $23.44. I paid $6.32, and my profit was $17.11. And I will keep you updated on my Thread Up Rescue Boxes, how much I make on them, and it'll be interesting to see how much I make on them versus how much I predict that I will make on them. Then the next one was a really pretty pair of shoes. They were the J. Crew Calf Hair Wedges, and they sold for $33.54. My earnings were $21.05. I paid $5.99 at the regular Goodwill store, and it was really interesting. I found these shoes, and there was just one, and I looked and looked on the shelf, and there wasn't another one, and I was like, oh no, I really wanted them. They were really cute. And then I was shopping through the store, and up on top of a rack where there were like hats and stuff, I found the other shoe. So I grabbed it, raced back over to the shoes, and got the other pair. So I was really happy I was able to find both the shoes. And they took 49 days to sell, and my profit was $15.05. Then the next one, this one was also, I think, in that same Goodwill haul where I selected items for the giveaway. This was a snowsuit, which I didn't put that in because I didn't want to send a snowsuit in summer. But guess what? I listed it in the summer and it sold in the summer. This was the Polar Edge Silver Series Snow Bibs. They sold for $31.95. My earnings were $19.11. I paid $1.27 at the bins, and they took 49 days to sell. My profit was $17.84. So that is why I just look at the item and think, will this sell at some point? How is the sell-through rate? I think that's one of the most important things, is looking at how many items are currently out there and how many are sold. And it is really good if you have at least as many have sold as are out there. And if that's good, then I will pick it up even if it's off season, because I know it will sell eventually. Then the next thing, I sold several of these. I had just gotten a liquidation box in of these trapeze, Free People Count Me In trapeze tunics. And I've gotten these in several times in several different boxes. And wow, the largest just sell like that. I sold out of all four larges within just a matter of days. One sold for $25.64, one sold for $18. So my earnings were, one was $22.56, the other was $15.84. I paid $8.50 on this. And so my profit on one was $14.06. And my profit on the other was $7.34. And then I sold one on Mercari too. So I'm going to jump ahead for just a second. Looks like my profit on Mercari was $12.97. So right in the middle of that. So I like getting those in when I have previously already ordered that specific item, and then I can see on the manifest that it's on another one. I think, oh, well, I ordered that, and all I have to do is relist or change my quantities. And so that's a great strategy also. One last thing that I sold, the eighth item that I sold on eBay, was the Intimately Free People Veronica bra. This is such a pretty bra. It sold for $20.89. My earnings were $15.33. I paid $5.50, and my profit was $9.83. And again, I probably got about 10 of these in different sizes, so super easy to list. Then I had one sale on Mercari. Next week, Mercari will be much better. And it was that trapeze tunic, and it sold for $25 plus $4.80 postage for a gross amount of $29.80. My earnings were $21.47, and my profit was $12.97. So that is everything that I sold for last week, and I will pop up the numbers now so that you can see how I did on each platform and what my actual profit was. So my gross sales were $859.59. Money back in the bank was $634.76. My cost of goods was pretty low this week, only $169.39. I had no refunds again, 2 weeks in a row, yay! And so my profit was $465.39, so pretty low, but the only thing I listed last week, I listed the 15 items from the ThredUp Rescue Box, and that was it. And then I relisted a couple things, but I did not have much time. The time that I was actually home, I spent working on YouTube videos. So, you know, if I'm profiting $465 and I am not having a lot of time to work, I think that is excellent. My profit was 54% of my gross sales. And then I will let you just look, if you wanna look at them more closely, you can always pause the video and look at each platform, but I ended up profiting $336.64 on Poshmark, $115.77 on eBay, and $12.97 on Mercari. So I am pleased with that week considering the amount of time that I had to put in and that I went on vacation for part of the week. I am very pleased with those sales and very grateful that I am able to make that money working from home. So if you enjoyed this video and got any value out of it, if you would consider taking a moment to give me a thumbs up, it will really help my video to tell YouTube that this is a valuable video and to possibly put out there for more people to see. Thank you so much for watching and have a great day. Bye.